All right, classic Italian dish, known in some parts of the world just simply as spaghetti and meatballs, but known to the kind of more informed, if you will, as a Sunday gravy. Basically, gravy is a tomato sauce that you put some sort of a meat in, right? Whether or not it's going to be in this particular case, we're going to go meatballs, we're going to go sausages, and we're going to go with some spare ribs over here. Basically, when you have meat in a tomato sauce, it becomes a gravy. So whether or not your family calls it sauce or gravy, that's kind of a matter of opinion and debate. I won't get into that one with you. But most people, like I said, they just go by that logic. Once you introduce meat to it, it's officially a gravy. Like I always say, get the prep work done in advance. Once you get everything cut, you get all the meat cut, all the onions cut, everything like that, it's gonna go so much smoother. It's gonna be so much easier to put this whole thing together. So let me walk you through the lineup over here. Chopped onions, we got minced garlic, we get chopped parsley, grated cheese, we got some flavored breadcrumbs. I picked this up at a local place that I go to, J. Pace and Son in Saugus. That's where I get basically all my meats, all my groceries. Really good stuff. A little expensive, but high quality stuff. Really good, well worth the price. Definitely recommend you check that out. There's a couple locations in the area. As far as the sauce itself is concerned, just pristine ground and peeled. Stuff works really good. Also picked it up at Pace's over here. We're going to use this for the meatballs. This is basically beef, pork, and veal. It's a triple mix. It's all been ground into one. We also got some fresh cut basil. One of my little secrets here, just a dash of mint we're gonna put in there, so some fresh cut stuff will work pretty good. We got the sausages over here. It's a garlic and cheese sausage. Already cut them down to size. Got a couple of pork spare ribs over here. And crazy little thing, I'm gonna show you a little bit more about this in a minute, but cut yourself up a small carrot over here, and we'll talk about why you do that a little bit later. All right, let's talk about putting the meatballs together, and this is actually pretty easy. You've got the meat that I showed you a second ago, right? It's that triple mix of the veal, pork, and the beef. Now I have 1 pound of that, so I just basically broke that into thirds. And one thing that I forgot to mention, also gonna need 2 eggs for this. So basically figure 1 pound, 2 eggs will do just fine for you. Just threw one of the eggs already cracked into the bottom of the pan, and I like to layer everything. When I'm mixing things up, I don't wanna just shove everything in there, dump things on top of it, and then go with my hands and mix it up. Things are gonna not distribute evenly if you do that, okay? You take the time to layer things, you're gonna find that it's a lot more consistent. You have things spread out through whatever it is that you're mixing at a better consistency versus a lot of flavor focused in one little area and not too much flavor in another. So, like I said, just going by that logic, I like to layer things out. So I'll start off with the egg in there, a little bit of that flavored breadcrumb mix, just a touch of grated cheese. Fresh chopped parsley in there, a little bit of garlic, and some chopped onion. Now I'm gonna come in, throw a piece of meat in there, and I'm just gonna kind of keep on repeating this process and get everything laid out until I get all my meat in there. All right, now I've got that in there. I got everything all layered. One egg over the top, and just come back. Go ahead and mix it up. And don't be shy with it. Easy way to do it, just make a fist, let it all squeeze out through your fingers, just like that there. Work it over. And if you think you could add some more breadcrumbs, you think you could add anything else to it as you kind of mix things up a little bit, you can go right ahead. But all right, so now that you got all the meat mixed together with everything else, just get out a cooking tray, throw a little piece of tinfoil in it. And what I always do is I just always hit that piece of tinfoil with a little cooking spray. And then whatever size you want your meatballs, I mean, basically I kind of like the golf ball size myself. You want to go tennis ball size, it's up to you. I find the bigger you make them, the more prone they are to kind of breaking apart in the sauce over there. Whereas if you make them a little tighter, a little bit denser, they kind of keep their shape, keep their form a little bit better. So yeah, that's maybe a little bit bigger than a golf ball, but that won't be too bad. So now that you get all the meatballs rolled, last thing we're going to do is we're just going to coat them in a little bit of olive oil, and then we're going to throw them in the oven, 350 for 30 minutes. We're not going to be done with them just yet. We don't want to cook the meatballs all the way through. They're going to cook the rest of the way through when they're in the sauce. So even if you don't go quite the full 30 minutes, you'll probably be all right, but 30 is a good target to shoot for. Now, one little thing here, you may have noticed this meatball originally was a lot bigger when you saw it in the frame there a couple seconds ago. As you make these meatballs, one thing that people forget is they'll make a meatball, it's, hey, this one's real big, this one's, you know, a little bit smaller, and they just don't get that consistency right. When you get everything done, eyeball all these things out, and then what you can do is you can kind of take a little bit off of this one, put it on that one. Okay, this one here is a little bit too big, put it on that one, it's a little bit too small. You even things out, and you get a better consistency of size all across the board if you do it that way. So don't think that you roll it, throw it in there, it's done. You get some of them that are size of, you know, basically the size of tennis balls, and you get some of them the size of grapes, right? try to get a nice consistency. And best way, by the way, that I think to go ahead and coat these meatballs, as kind of crude as this seems, just go ahead, get a little olive oil in the palm of your hands. See, some people, what they do is they throw a little olive oil mix into the actual, I don't think there's anything wrong with doing, but I find that if you just coat these meatballs, a little bit of oil in the palm of your hands, kind of like I'm doing right now before you throw them in the oven, comes out a lot better. You throw that olive oil into the mix, that olive oil seeps into the meat itself, the meat doesn't stay as tight, you get meatballs that break apart in the pan a lot, in the sauce pot rather, a lot easier. So this here, I think, just my little opinion, my little technique, helps to keep them cooked in the oven, obviously. You get that oil on them. At the same time too, throwing them on the outside like this, as opposed to letting them go on the inside, letting that olive oil seep to the inside, helps keep them nice and intact for you. All right, so we got the meatballs in the oven right now. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna start to pre-cook the ribs and the sausage over here. And just get a pan, a little bit of olive oil, garlic, and the onions. Get it up on high heat, and once it starts going, I'll take it down maybe towards a little bit closer to a medium heat, maybe just a touch above. And we're not looking to go ahead and cook these through all the way. Actually, quite the opposite. All you wanna do is just kind of pre-cook them a little bit on each side. Kind of just get them cooked partially, because what's gonna happen is once you get them into the sauce pot and you get the sauce going in a little bit, we'll probably just stick to four of these right now. They're gonna cook the rest of the way in there because we're gonna basically get that sauce up to a boil, then we're gonna bring it down to a low setting and we're gonna let it sit there for a couple of hours. So you don't have to freak out and really cook this all the way. This is really just cooking them partway through so that they'll cook the rest of the way in the sauce. All right, so got the sauce pot on the stove over here. Got some garlic and onions in there with a little bit of olive oil. That's ready to go. And then we get basically all of our ingredients here. Oregano can't hurt. Maybe throw a little bit in. I'd like to get the fresh stuff if I had it. I forgot to pick it up at the store. Need a little bit of red table wine and some granulated sugar. All right, we got our cans of tomato sauce over there. Judging by how much meat we ended up having, I decided to go. All I gotta do now, by the way, just go ahead and throw that sauce in. Decided to go with one more can, given that we had so much meat over here. Take a look at that. That's gonna be a lot of meat. That's gonna end up filling this pot up. I don't even know if three cans is gonna cut it. We'll take a look at something right here. Take a look at the level that you're at right now. Once you bulk everything up with all that meat, that's gonna be quite a bit higher than where it's at right now. All right, you got everything in the sauce pot. Next thing you wanna do, just come by, give a little stir so you make sure that stuff doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan right there. And then we'll just start working some of our ingredients in. So basically at this point, I got a little bit of garlic left. Go ahead, I'll dump all that in there. We'll get rid of it. Parsley, I don't wanna go too overboard with, but I don't wanna be stingy either. So I won't use all of it. Get just a little bit in there. Onions, I don't really go too heavy on the onions, but we'll throw a few more in. Touch of oregano. And usually I save the mint towards the ends. Put a little bit of that basil in there. You don't want to go too aggressive with it. And then, Pete Clemenza's little secret, just a little bit of sugar to get it sweet. Those of you Godfather fans out there, you'll get the reference with Pete Clemenza. Just a touch of red wine, not too much, just a little bit to add some flavor to it. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna mix that in. And then, shouldn't take very long at all, given that we're on a high setting. Once we get this mixed in and I get this up to a boil, it's just as simple as throwing in the meat and letting it simmer. All right, so we've got the meatballs that have been in the oven for 350 at 30, and then I pan-fried the pork and the garlic like I was telling you about, and that didn't even take me close to a half an hour. It probably took me all of about 15 minutes to do that. And then for the last 15 minutes, I threw that in the oven too, something you can do just to help it cook. You don't have to do it. Like I said, it's all gonna cook in the sauce pot here over the next couple hours. All right, we got that sauce boiling. It's now ready to go ahead and put the meat in. All right, we've got everything in the pot over here. Just make sure we get everything submerged. We'll give it a little bit of a stir. And we still got this up on high heat right now. And like I said, you can see with where we started off at, everything that we had in there, all that sauce, you can see how much volume all that meat's taken up. So, wise thing to do, maybe buy an extra can of tomato sauce and just keep a couple around the house like I do. If you ever underestimate it, better to have it, not need it, than need it and not have it. Anyway, we got it up to a boil right now. Just go ahead. I'm gonna put this down in a low setting. Throw the lid on, and that should be done in about 2 hours. Every so often, come by and spot check it, taste the sauce a little bit, see how it's going. If you have to, you get all your stuff over here, all the different things. You've got parsley, basil. Oop, you know what? Almost forgot about the mint. Glad that I showed you guys that. What I do, just for a little bit of extra dimension of flavor, just put in a little sprinkle of mint. Not too much. Don't want to be aggressive with it. And lastly, a lot of acid in this sauce. So a good thing to do, throw maybe half a carrot in there. Let's go ahead and mix everything up. And again, the purpose of that carrot is just to take the acid content out of there as much as possible. You can also use a potato. Works just as good. And like I said, come by every so often, spot check it, give it a taste. If you have to, go ahead and add a couple of the seasonings that you have over here. Low heat, should be ready to go in 2 hours. So, and now I'm gonna let you know the real secret. Right here, 2 small ice cubes, okay? After about a half an hour, you just dump 2 small ice cubes in there, just like that. And this is the big secret. You let those ice cubes just disintegrate in there. And what's gonna happen is, it's gonna basically break the sauce down just enough so that it's not too thick. It's gonna give it just enough of a watery consistency to it so it's not too heavy. And the temperature of that ice being a little bit too cold is going to react against the hot temperature of the sauce. We have it on low heat right now. And that temperature reaction is going to spike the flavor. Okay, little secret that not too many people know about. Actually, that's complete and total bullshit. But when I was a little kid and my Uncle John, who makes a great Sunday gravy, showed me how to make gravy, he said that to me and I said to myself, whoa, I can't believe this. I'm like getting in on some big culinary secret no one knows about. And for a couple of years, I thought that, and then he told me he was just lying. So anyway, I don't know. I thought I'd share that with you. If you decide to make this for your friends, just say that. It sounds really good. And, you know, I used to think my uncle was like, you know, a world-renowned chef, you know, with information like that. I'm sure people think the same thing of you. One thing, though, in all seriousness and joking aside, you can see it's a pretty thick, it's a pretty heavy sauce. If you want to, when basically you get everything in here and you get it all boiling, don't be afraid to dump maybe half a cup or 1 cup of water, whatever you think it needs. Start off with something light. And if you think it needs to add more, add some more. And this is going to be a pretty heavy sauce, but I don't think it's going to be too heavy. But if you do want it to be a little bit lighter, you can put a little water in there. And okay, just threw the linguine in, and this is what I use. I use the DiCecco No. 7. It's really good stuff. It's a little pricey, but trust me, for what you're getting in terms of quality, you can't go wrong with this. It's definitely worth it. But anyway, whatever you got here as far as linguine is concerned, you're going to see on the box there'll be a time on there. What I usually do is whatever it says, say that it's 11 minutes. I usually give it about 1 minute less than that. I spot check it. If it seems like it's ready to go, then I take it off. And I'm not afraid to take it off at 1 minute underneath that. The reason being is that when you take this and you have the linguine sitting in the sink and it's cooling down in the strainer, there's still so much heat in that linguine is still cooking itself. So don't be shy about taking it off a minute or two earlier if you think the linguine is ready. All right, so here's everything all broken down. We got the meatballs. We got the spare ribs and the sausage. We got the sauce all off and it's lonesome. And then over here, just get a pan out. Just put a little bit of that sauce in there. What I like to do with my linguine, you've seen me do this before on some of my episodes here, if you will. Just get a little bit of that linguine in the pan and just work it in. Let that linguine take the flavor of the pasta this way, all right? You're still gonna put that sauce back on the linguine when you serve this, and I'll show you the presented and finished product here in a minute. But let a little bit of this linguine just absorb that flavor by itself. It makes a big difference. All right, there you have it, the finished product over here. Get a little bit more sauce on top of it, maybe give it a little dry garnish there with some fresh parsley, top it all off, a little grated cheese, 2 meatballs, 1 link of sausage, a little spare rib on the side, whole bit of linguine. probably want to lead up this maybe with a little, I don't know, chicken cutlets or a little eggplant rollatini. But as you get into it, get yourself a good glass of red wine, maybe progress on to a nice cannoli for dessert. Wash that down with a nice coffee or an espresso, a shot of Zambuca. Life is good. What could possibly be better than this? The ultimate comfort food, Sunday gravy over linguine. Just doesn't get much better than that. What you eating there? You having some macaroni? What, you got a meatball? You got a sausage in there? It's good, isn't it? Ah, oh, you're a good girl.